All right, let's pretend that the tap behind me is on full blast.
Clearly, the pipes leading to this tap are blocked somewhere along the way, but more about that later. Women in the academic workforce continue to be underrepresented in leadership positions and concentrated in lower rungs of universities. In Australia, the academic career hierarchy consists of five levels. Level A, associate lecturer, through to level E, professor. And this progression has been referred to as the academic pipeline. So, I am a female with academic career aspirations. Yet current statistics show that I would be 2.5 times less likely to move from level B to level C, and 4 times less likely to be promoted from level C to level D than male colleagues. At the level of professor, these inequalities compound, and the inequity at this level has been referred to as the glass ceiling in academia. Internationally, there have been 2 general gender equity approaches. These are federal legislation that encourages gender equity, like we have in Australia, and state intervention, where organizations have to have a legislated minimum number of women on their board, like in some parts of Europe. Neither approach has been successful in actually achieving gender equity. Now, going back to my tap. If this was my tap at home, I would call a plumber who would come and have a look. Would the plumber just add water to the spout, like the legislated quota? Would he or she try and force a larger quantity of water through the base, hoping that this would increase the tap's output? Probably neither. What a plumber would do is come and investigate where the water was getting stuck and unblock these bottlenecks. My research is proposing that to achieve gender equity in academia, a similar approach must be adopted. Most current research has focused on the glass ceiling when, like with my tap, this is really just the final outcome of the various bottlenecks. There is a significant lack of research exploring these bottlenecks, and my study will therefore aim to identify barriers located specifically at level B and level C that are slowing down the careers of female academics. My study will be qualitative and consist of over 60 interviews with male and female academics, as well as a variety of stakeholders such as HR professionals and university leadership. Since gender inequity is an issue at universities across the world, my study can provide Australian as well as international universities with valuable data. Female academics can only truly progress through the academic pipeline equally once these bottlenecks have been explored and addressed. Thank you.